Yay, second day of our Florida trip. First stop is Fort Caroline, which belongs to Tim Kwan Ecological and Historic Preserve. So first we go to the visitor center, and there's a museum in there that talk about the ecology and some history about how French first arrived in US. So this is like, later we'll see the French fort when they first settled here. It's a cool national park. Okay, so we are at Fort Caroline. It's part of the Timucuan Ecological and Historical Preserve. So this park is actually dedicated to like first French immigrant to North America. Yep, in the museum there's lots of French artifacts from the 1500s. And now we're gonna go see the fort, and later some memorial as well. Yeah, we're gonna take a short hike and go there.
Okie dokie.
Okay, so this is one of the Indian Timucans' house. Damn, so many mosquitoes here. Alright, so here's the sign, Timucan, so the French made friend with the Indian, and then the trade and stuff. Yep, the Indian house. You can go in there and stuff. Okay, so we're gonna go head to the fort. Fort is this way. Fort. So here is one of the boating docks, and from here we can see Fort Caroline from across the ocean, which is a good view. Yeah, today we're gonna go to 5 national parks in one day. Yep, this counts as 2, Tim Kwan National Preserve and Fort Caroline National Memorial. So here we are inside Fort Caroline, the French settlement. It's not that big, but it looks really cool from aerial view. It's like a cool triangular shape. So the wall of these four are made with these wooden sticks. So this is actually a replica fort. It's according to historians' imagination and records. Here I'm inside Fort Caroline French settlement. It is said that tons of people get massacred here by the Spanish in the 1500s. I think this is a replica based on their educated guess. There's only like one cannon in this whole fort that's still in display, replica as well. And on the other side of the fort you can see the ocean. There is a moat. Maybe they put alligator in there. Like on Christina. Here's the main gate. Main gate of the fort. And you can see the French symbol there. Yep. Alright. And then, yeah, the kitchen is outside. You can see the pink kitchen over there. head to the next memorial.
So our next stop is Castillo de San Marco National Monument. So this is located in St. Augustine. It's actually a really beautiful historic town, lots of things to do there. I wish you could stay longer. The ticket to the fort is $10 per person. It'll be on the pricey side, but if you have yearly passes, you can bring 4 people for free. So here we are inside the fort. There are some weapon demonstrations, and every room you can go in, there's a historical display that you can see. So here we are at the second floor of this fort. You can see the fort from up high, which is very good view, and you can see the ocean around it. believe this fort belonged to Spanish, and which was used when they fight the French, which was Fort Caroline, the fort that we first visited this morning.
Yay, finally lunchtime. So we got calzone. Like, first time ordering calzone ever. So this is half of calzone. This is the other half. And we also have some salad right there. Yep. Very cheesy. It's like a pizza flipped inside out or something. Is it good? Yeah.
So this is our next fort, Fort Matanzas National Monument. And this at this fort, you can buy a Actually, it's free ticket, boat ticket to across the river to see the fort itself. The fort actually has been restored, and it's really cool to check it out. It's actually related to the previous fort.
Okay, we're boarding the ship. Boarding. There on the far.
So with these cannon, the Spanish can see like enemy ship from far away, miles away, and shoot at them to prevent them from coming into this area. So the boat ride is only like 5 minutes, and we get to stay on the island for like 15 to 20 minutes. Thank you.
to the observation tower.
Have you?
Second observation deck, and here you can see the ocean.
Way back, we saw some bird eating fish. Live footage. So this concludes our fourth visit today. We're leaving for Mantandas. So next stop, we're actually going to drive a little further to near Orlando, the Canaveral National Seashore. Stay tuned. So we went to the north part of the national seashore, and there's a visit center there, and you can watch a 8-minute clip about the national seashore and buy some souvenirs at the visit center.
Heading into the trail. I think we're the only person here. Woo! Turtle Mound! It's cool. So jungle-y in here.
Turtle Mound.
Oh yeah, it's a dumpster for Indian. They put their oyster shell and then they make a mountain out of it. Yep.
They can find out a lot about the Indians from their food, their culture, and everything.
Yep. Dump. This platform that you can go up there and see. We're going to another trail. Yeah. See ya.
What you see is the Atlantic Ocean across, and beneath us is this oyster thrown away by the Indian a long time ago, which made this mountain. So this is a very long natural seashore, and there are several places that you can go down the boardwalk to get beach access. Not many people today. It's kind of rainy and cold. So in the hotel, we clean our shells and we dry them. So here are loot from the national seashores. Go. gonna make some crab using them when I get home. Hope you enjoy the video of us visiting 5 national parks in a day, and here's me doing something crazy. Alright, I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye!